Thank you. What a crowd. What a beautiful crowd. Look at that. You can't even see the end of it. What a great crowd. Thank you very much. Hello, Wisconsin. We're back. We're back. We're going to win. We're going to win this state. We win this state. You know what? It's over. We win Wisconsin. I've treated Wisconsin very well. 4 days from now, we're going to win this state, and we are going to win 4 more beautiful years in the land. With your support, we will continue to bring back your jobs, cut your taxes, cut regulations, support our great police, defend our borders. Without borders, we don't have a country, do we? Protect our Second Amendment, protect religious liberty, and ensure more products are proudly stamped with those beautiful words, made in the USA. We're starting to do that. You remember I used to say 4 years ago, we're going to bring back the words, Merry Christmas. We did, right? Merry Christmas. Those big department stores, they like Happy New Year. I said, no, you can say them both, but you can't do one without the other. Merry Christmas is back. You notice that, right? And pretty soon we're going to be there. Joe Biden will shut down your state's economy, wipe out your factories, ship your jobs to China. To China that's paid them off, by the way. China that's paid them off. You know that, right? Although you don't get too much news, but you get enough. You know what's going on. They don't like giving you the news. Punish your family with a $4 trillion tax hike. Eliminate private health care. 180 million people have private health care. They want to take it away and send your state into a catastrophic, do you want to use the word recession or depression? Because the word is depression. Biden has vowed to eliminate the entire U.S. oil industry, no fracking, no energy, and gas prices going $5, $6, $7 for a gallon. How do you like $2 gasoline? Good? There'll be no heating in the winter, no air conditioning in the summer, and no electricity, whatever the hell you want it. Right now, you have it made. You're so lucky. You are so lucky I'm your president. And your team is doing a good job, right? They're doing a good job, right? They are doing a good job. And while I'm president, America will proudly remain energy independent. How does that sound? First time. You're energy independent. We're the biggest in the world. Nobody close. Biden will deliver poverty, misery, depression. I will deliver jobs, 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 and the greatest economy in the history of our country. That's going to be next year. You see it. Yesterday, it was announced last quarter. Our economy grew at the astonishing speed, 33.1%, the largest GDP growth ever recorded, and not just by a little bit, by more than double. Right? And that was in 1952, but more than double. Think of it. It's never been anything like that for any country, not only ours, for any country. In the past 5 months, we've created a record 11.4 million American jobs. We have a super V. I used to talk about the V. This is no longer a V. This is a super V. This is despite the fact that the Democrat governors have states shut down, right? Gee, does that sound, hey, does that sound familiar to you? Middle-class family income is up more than $6,000 under my administration, far greater than the past administration. I mean, that was not up. That was doing very poorly. We created the greatest economy in history, and now we're doing it again. Make America great again, again. We did it once. That hat. See, that hat is now obsolete. It's called Make America Great Again, Again. In a very recent poll, Gallup, they said 56% of Americans said they were doing better today than they were 4 years ago, and we're rounding the turn on a pandemic, and it's 56, and it's the highest number they've ever recorded. So we're doing something right. Joe Biden spent the last 47 years outsourcing your jobs, opening your borders and sacrificing American blood and treasure in endless foreign wars in countries that most of you have never even heard of. I mean, think of it. And you know, at the debate, did anybody see the debate by any chance? So during the debate, he'd say, well, we're going to do this. I said, Joe, why didn't you do it? We're going to do that. We're going to do this and that, this and that. Joe, why didn't you do it, Joe? That was an easy debate. 91% to 9%, they said. That was good. That's like a great football game. No, I said, but Joe, why didn't you do it? Well, I don't know exactly. And then the last question was a disaster. Basically, he said, no more oil, no more fracking, no more anything. I said, did he say that? And I just said, we just left a great place, you know that. It was a little cold there. You know, this is like warm by comparison to that. This is a pleasure. That was cold. I said, let's cut this a little bit shorter. But we have a big crowd. You know, we had a big crowd. No matter where we go, we have these massive crowds. And I'm going up to Minnesota. We're going to Minnesota, which we have a chance, not since 1972, think of it. So those are odds that aren't good, but they like us up there with the Iron Range, all the things I've done for them up there, and helping them when the rioters and anarchists attacked. We took over, and we did a great job. But they should have called us 2 weeks earlier, in all fairness. If the federal government called us 2 weeks earlier, that would have been nice, you know? You would have had no problem. It took us about, what, 25 minutes to solve the problem, right? Boom. They just marched down. But we're going, and the governor just informed us, though, that so we have 25,000 people. 25,000 people. That's a lot. You got a lot here. 25,000 people in Minnesota. They said, we can only have 250 people. So they were hoping I'd say, oh, well, we can't do that. Let's turn around. No, we're going to go. We're going to go. Be a very interesting thing. Even if we see 250 people, can I be honest with you? Everybody understands. You can't play those games. That could very well, aside from Omar, Omar is our secret weapon. Ilhan Omar, that's our secret weapon in Minnesota. Now, she doesn't love our country, you know? I don't like people that don't love our country, I don't. And the other, and you know all about this because you've had your things. The other is we want law and order. We got to have law and order. You look at what's going on in Philadelphia, you can't have that. You have to let the police do what they do. I mean, they have to do their job. When I watch that, again, Democrats, it's all Democrats. When I watch that, if people are looting stores and you have the anarchists, the rioters, but they're looting stores, they're walking out with dishwashers. They're walking out, the guy has a dishwasher, he couldn't even, he's pushing it. They're washing, I mean, they have television sets, and they're walking, and the police are standing there. And those police don't want to be standing there. They don't want to do that. They want to be able to do their job, but they're not. And you can't have that. We need law and order, as we had right here. As we did a very good job right here, we got the endorsement of everybody. Everybody in your state, every law enforcement group in your state endorsed us. I think every law enforcement group in the country endorsed us. I asked Sleepy Joe during one of the debates, I said, Joe, who endorsed you from law enforcement? And he couldn't answer the question. Now, that's possibly that happened, but he's got a very bad memory, too. He was going, let me think. Give me about 20 minutes. I'll figure it out. I doubt he has any. I think we have everybody. Florida, Texas, Oklahoma. Chicago endorsed us. Isn't that nice? Chicago. With all the problems they have. And they have a great group of people from law enforcement. They could stop those problems. I mean, you see what's going on there. New York has gone through the roof. New York's finest. We have New York's finest. These are incredible police. They could do the job, but they have to be allowed to do the job. And they endorsed me. First time in the history of the police force in New York that they endorsed a presidential candidate. So it was pretty cool. So Joe Biden tried to cut Medicare during the course of his terms, and he worked very hard in cutting Social Security. You wouldn't believe that, right? And we actually put it up. We put it on, where is that screen? For places that we really like, we use the screen. It's very expensive. You'll see. Biden was a cheerleader for NAFTA, which is the worst trade deal ever made, and China's entry into the World Trade Organization, which cost Wisconsin 130 minimum manufacturing jobs. At every turn, Biden betrayed American workers and twisted his knife into the back of Wisconsin workers. You suffered as much as anybody. Biden's also spent half a century, really a half a century, betraying black Americans. He devastated black families with the 1994 crime bill, and he called black youth super predators, a term that's a terrible term. Super predators over and over again. And then he wonders why they're not doing well with the black vote. You know, the black vote's not turning out for him. See, now we don't have to go by the fake polls. Now you see what's happening. He's not doing well with the black vote. You know why? Because they remember that, and they remember 1994, and they remember him calling everybody a super predator, and that's a term that they don't like. That's a term that nobody would like. But they're not showing up to vote, and others aren't either. You know, we're doing great in Florida. We're doing great in Ohio. We're doing great in North Carolina, who was fantastic. I think we're doing really good in Pennsylvania. We're doing very good in Pennsylvania. I think we're doing good all over the place. You want to know the truth? I think we're doing good all over. We're doing great here. You know, I think they just said to here we're either tied or one up or tied or one down. You know, it's like essentially tied. I don't know how the hell I can be tied with this guy. He's shot. He said, sir, you're tied in Wisconsin. You know, normally that means because we have like a hidden voter. People that don't want to talk about it, they just go out and vote for Trump. I never knew. Should I be complimented by that? We don't want to talk about it. Leave us alone. We're voting for Trump, right? So when you're tied, that's a good thing. But they said, sir, we're tied. And I said, that's interesting. And then the fake Washington Post, ABC, right? Did you see that? So we are tied. I was up here 2 days ago. We gave a great speech. That was a cold one. We gave a speech at a racetrack. We got a lot of people, and it was freezing, but I got through that. There was no way that I leave early or the great people of Wisconsin, because you don't know about that. There was no way. Anyway, this poll, so we're tied. Let's say we're tied. One up, one down. We're right, boom, very close. I think we're going to take it easily, actually. I think we're going to take it because we're going to have a turnout probably on Tuesday. You know, our people like to vote. They like to vote on Tuesday, not even on Sunday or Monday. So Washington Post and ABC, it's called Washington Post ABC poll. They come out 17 down. Donald Trump is 17 down in Wisconsin. I said, wait a minute. I just left a crowd of 25,000 people or more. They were going crazy. That wasn't a second place crowd. You know, we know a second place crowd. That was not a second place crowd. And they did it to me 4 years ago with Crooked Hillary. They had me. He's down 12 2 weeks ago, remember? Washington Post, ABC, crooked as hell. It's called suppression polls. You know what it does? It suppresses the vote. You get depressed. You like Trump. You know, I like the president, but let's, and in the case 4 years ago, I like Donald Trump. He's going to do a good job. We did more than we said we were going to do. We did more than any administration has ever done in the first 3.5 years. But it's a suppression thing. So they came out 12 down. We actually wrote them legal letters and everything, and then they changed the vote. Can you believe it? They changed it. Well, we were one down, but that was the day before the election. 2 weeks to go, 12 down. But this one was 17 down in your state. And I said, you know, I could be three down. I could also be three up. I could be three down, I could be four down, I could also be three up or four up. One thing I know, I'm not 17 down. So I called up the best pollster, a guy, it doesn't matter, let's just call him John. His first name is John. I said, John, could I ask you a question? I just left Wisconsin. We had a tremendous crowd. It was like a love fest. And then I wake up, true, and then I wake up like 2 days later, and I see a poll, Washington Post. It's all over the place. You know, they love it, all the fake news. Look at all of them back. They're fake. Among the most dishonest people in the world. Now they have a new thing. They don't report. They don't report on, you know, criminality like with the Biden crime family. You know, they don't want to report. But fortunately, we have guys like Ron Johnson that are willing to say it like it is. It's true. It's actually very true what I just said. He's fantastic, but we'll get to him later. Your senator is fantastic. So you take a look, and I said, I'm not 17 now. And he's a really smart guy. He says, no, you're not. I said, but don't they have to pay a price like, you know, they did it 12 down 4 years ago and now said, isn't it a bad thing? He said, yeah, but they want you to lose. I said, well, why don't they make it that I'm three down or two down or, you know, make it like believable? No, no, three down or two down is no good. Because if they go three down, two down, four, even five, I said, make it five. He said, no, no good. Because that means you have a chance. That might even bring people out. They want to make it so bad. And they said, no, they're very smart people. They're very vicious people. And they purposely make these polls phony. They're phony polls. And he said, the only way they really can do it, they have to make it so that the people here think you're 17 down and they don't go and vote because they say it's hopeless. Five down, four down, three down means, gee, he has a chance. 17 down means, darling, let's go to dinner. Let's have a wonderful dinner. And then watch come, we'll come home and watch the president lose. But we're not going to lose. We're going to win. We're going to win. True. True story. Isn't that some story? Isn't that sad? And he knows the people. He said, no, this is the way they do it. They're very, and then they came with another state where I was 10 down that I'm going to actually win the state. It's a terrible thing. We have tremendous dishonesty in polling, but not only polling. I mean, the stories. And now there's something that happened. We call them freedom of the press, right? This is the opposite of freedom of the press because they now suppress. It's now suppression of the press because now they have stories and they don't want to have. You cannot get a story out on Biden criminality. We have the laptop from hell. We have the worst things anyone's ever seen. And they just won't write about it. And that includes big tech. So you know what I'm doing? I'm here's who I'm facing. A corrupt Democrat party that spied on my campaign and we caught them. They spied on the campaign. Thank you. See, I never do anything to just, you know, to like encourage it because they say, he led the chant. Lock him up. Lock him up. He led the chant against Crooked Hillary. All she did was get rid of 33,000 emails when she got a subpoena from Congress. She deleted them. She acid washed them. And then she took a hammer to her telephones and she beat the hell out of the phone. I've gotten rid of a lot of phones. I've never hit them with a hammer. Has anybody hit the phone with a hammer? I don't know. Well, we'll have to tell that to Ron Johnson. We can put that. That is a strange event, Ron. I'll bet you never hit your phone with a hammer. No, it's called you throw it out, right? You throw out your phone. You start all over again. Now, we got a corrupt bunch of people. But think of it. I'm all up here alone. Think of this. I have the Democrats. They impeached me for making a phone call. No, I make a phone call to a man I never met, the president, the new president of Ukraine. Congratulations, congratulations. It was a perfect phone call. Everybody said it. 297-0 in the House, the Republicans voted, right? It's like this perfect phone call. Congratulate. Everyone's telling me, please call him. He just won. Oh, do I have, you know, I'm busy, right? I say, okay, I'll call him. Get the president. Nice guy. Congratulations, blah, blah, blah. By the way, if you see any crime, because we're supposed to have a crime, because it's a lot of corruption there, please report it to the Attorney General of the United States. Oh, we should impeach him. I got impeached over a perfect phone call. But they didn't know we had the call essentially recorded. Thank goodness we had, because they were making up stories, right? They died when they heard we had it transcribed by very professional people. They died, because it had already been way down the track by the time they found that out. I had to do that. We called up. We said, do you mind if we put your phone call on public record. They said, why would that be? It was just a congratulatory call. I said, well, you'll find out. These are bad people. So here's what we have. We have the Democrats. Now we have big tech. Now we also have the rhinos. Now the rhinos in many ways are worse than all of them. And most of the rhinos I beat because, you know, they were all representing one of the 17 because we had 18 running. But they were most of whom I get along with. Some of them I don't like. I could tell you the good ones or the bad ones. But I beat all of these guys. And they end up being rhinos and bad people. And here we are, and we're president. We're going to have, I think we're going to have something that's even better than what we did 4 years ago. I really believe that. I really believe that. Because you don't have crowds like this and be on the losing stick. You know, you leave here and you say, gee, that doesn't sound like a second place. You can't even see the end of the crowd. That doesn't look like a second place finisher. So when you hear about suppression, you have some very nice people up there, about two of them. But when you hear about, that's right. I know every one of them. There, some of them are great, actually. But we're going to have a big victory. And this election is the most important election of our lifetime. This is a more important election than the last one. And I never thought I'd say it because they have gone so far radical left that we have to make this final step. And we're going to have be normalizing our country, really normalizing our country. And you know what else normalizes its success? I'll tell you, before the plague came in from China, they should have never let it happen. But before the plague came in from China, I was getting calls from people that you would least expect. It was time. We had the best numbers, the best employment, the best everything, the stock market all-time high. Everything was the best. And they were like, let's talk. And it was happening. And then we got hit with the plague. Success brings this country together. And we're going to have success next year. We're going to have success next year. You know, the most successful year Wisconsin ever had was last year. You're going to have a year. I mean, unless some guy gets in that wants to quadruple your taxes, which he wants to do. He's the only guy I've ever seen. We will raise your taxes. All my life, I've seen politicians say, we're going to cut your taxes. He's the only guy ever campaigning on, he's going to increase your taxes. In 2016, Wisconsin voted to fire this corrupt political establishment, and you elected an outsider as president who is finally putting America first. If I don't sound like a typical politician, it's because I'm not a politician, if that's okay. And if I don't always play by the rules of Washington and the Washington establishment, it's because I was elected to fight for you, and I fight harder for you than any president at any time in the history of our country. That's so nice. Thank you. That's a chant that has never been heard politically. Nobody's ever, even these people, there's never been a time. We like Ronald Reagan, we like people, but they've never had that chant, so it's an honor. Don't keep it going too long, because I'll start to cry. I'll go a little. And we can't tell President Xi of China that the president was crying because they said they loved him, right? And the fake news would report it. President Trump broke down in tears as they shouted. Somehow it doesn't work for us, right? We can't do that, right? Look at him. He goes, no way, you can't do it. No, we appreciate it. It is. It's a chant that nobody's ever heard before. It started happening like 6 weeks ago, and I said, man, that's very unusual. But it's a beautiful chant, and I appreciate it. I'm not just running against Sleepy Joe Biden. I'm running against the left-wing media, the big tech giants, and the Washington swamp, and it's deep and vicious. And they can't believe what's happening. They can't believe it. They would have taken most people out. Almost anybody would have been taken out. And I have been helped a lot by that man right there named Ron Johnson. I have. He's a tough guy, and he's a smart guy. And I knew it earlier than anybody else. I knew it. I had a meeting with Ron Johnson, and we were going over a very complex tax. Most people had no idea what we were even talking about. He understood it so good. I mean, he really understood it. So I knew a long time ago what you had. Don't lose him. Don't ever lose him. You need to show up in record numbers and deliver a blistering defeat to these corrupt forces, and they are corrupt as hell. They're trying to take over our country, and we caught them. They're coming for your guns, they're coming for your jobs, and they're coming for your freedom. Think about it. Your vote will stop them on November 3rd. Get out there, you gotta vote. It's the most important issue, one of the most truly important issues. You don't like to even mention it, but it's law and order. And I mentioned that to Biden during one of the debates. I said, hey, Joe, say the words law and order. Can you do it? He wouldn't do it because he didn't want to lose the radical left. He didn't want to lose them. Joe Biden and his party have spent the entire year inciting violence and hatred against our police officers, and he refuses to say you got to stop it. You cannot run through Portland to destroy the city. I mean, it's been going on. We could stop it in 30 minutes. You know, in Seattle, I said, I don't care. We waited and waited. The governor never called. We waited. I said, you got to go. And they took over a part of the city. I mean, this is even, to even talk about this, who would think of this, Seattle? And we were going in, and we told them, we're coming in the morning. And you know what they did that evening? They raised their hand and they left. That was the end of it. And a lot of people are paying a big price, by the way. But they raised their hands and they left. Or the statues. We signed a law. You knock down statues. They were knocking down statues all over the country. You knock down statues, you go to jail for 10 years. It's an old law. It's amazing how we haven't seen too much trouble with statues. There were groups that formed. They wanted to do it. They wanted. And then they said, let's get the hell out of here. 10 years. It says 10 years in prison. Old law that we reenacted. You could never get that passed today with this crazy group, Nancy Pelosi and crying Chuck Schumer. Crying Chuck Schumer and Nancy would never pass anything like that. They'd say, no, you're allowed to rip down anything you want. You know, we have a D.C. mayor that set up a commission, right, to talk about all of the things, cancel culture, let's talk about. They don't like the Washington Monument. They want it renamed or taken down. This was their recommendation. Don't worry about it. We're not doing, I promise you. They don't like the Thomas Jefferson Memorial because they don't like it. They don't even know why. Tell me why. And they don't like even the Lincoln Memorial, right? They don't like the Lincoln. So they wanted recommendations to change the name or take them down. And I said, I think this commission should be immediately disbanded because it's not going anywhere. But they are, I mean, this is a fact. Take down the Washington Monument. These people are stone cold crazy. You have to go out and you have to vote. Biden stands with the rioters and looters, and Biden wouldn't say anything about the report. They asked him about the report. He didn't want to comment. I have no comment. Do you want to take down the Washington Monument, sir? I have no comment on that. He has no clue. He never had much of a clue. Now we know. I stand with the heroes of law enforcement. These are great people, and we have to help them. If Biden wins, the rioters and the streets, they'll be running your federal government. They'll be running your government. No city, no family, and no community will be safe. The Biden-Harris, how about Harris? Kamala. Kamala. And you have to say her name right or she gets very upset, right? Even though she doesn't say it right, you know? But the Biden-Harris plan would end cash bail, releasing 400,000 dangerous criminals immediately onto your streets. Murderers and rapists. This is what's going on is crazy. When the violent mob came to a place known as Kenosha, did you ever hear of Kenosha? Because I did. Remember what I did? If I didn't activate immediately, Kenosha would not be there any longer. They were going to take it down. Biden opposed sending in the National Guard, and I insisted on it. And I frankly wish the governor asked me sooner. But at least he asked me, but we came in and that was over in about another 15 minutes, right? That didn't take long. That didn't take long. And we saved Kenosha, so you still have Kenosha. They knocked down, they burned a couple of buildings down. I went, I met with the people, and really good people. One was there 100 years, a photography store. It was 100 years. They burned down the store, but it's going to get rebuilt. But we stopped it. That whole area would have been burned to the ground. So we came in, and it was so easy, too. It's easy. But you sometimes have to meet force with force. You can't just stand back, sit back, and watch it take place, like they did in Minneapolis. And then we went in, and it took place very quickly. Like, usually if it takes, like, more than a half an hour to wipe the whole thing out, I say, you're not doing a very good job. Biden's running mate, the most liberal senator in America, even urged their supporters to donate to a fund that bailed out the rioters, took them right out of jail, including a cop killer or an attempted cop killer. Biden wants to lock down your homes. He's ready to lock it down. I mean, you guys are already in a lockdown, so you might not notice it as much. Hey, Governor, you got to open up your state here. You got to open it up. Got to open up your state. Got to open it up. You know, it's sad. It's sad. You got to go back. You understand? You're going to socially distance. You're going to do all the things you want to do. But, I mean, we're having these outdoor rallies. It's they say outdoor. Normally, we'd go into an arena. I actually like this stuff better, although sometimes it's snowing and sleet. I loved that last stop, but it was the rain was pouring, like, sideways. It was going that stuff. That's when you say, I love the indoor arenas, but I like these. With a day like this, it's so beautiful. It's great. Is there any place better to be than a Trump rally, though, seriously? It's great. But this election is a choice between a Trump super boom or a Biden depression. That's what it is. And it's also between opening up and keeping it closed. You see what's happening in Europe? They're trying it again. They're going to close up. They closed up and they destroyed their economy. Our economy is so much better, so much stronger, went down so much less, and now it's come up faster than any country in the world. But ours is between a safe vaccine, which is coming very shortly, it's a momentarily, or a devastating lockdown. That's what Biden wants to do, because he has no choice. He will not call the shots. He will not call the shots. And everybody knows it. Thanks to our historic campaign to slash red tape and mobilize industry, we will deliver a safe vaccine to the American people in literally over the next few weeks, we think, over the next few weeks. There was a lot of pressure. There was a lot of pressure on everybody, including on the FDA, not to let this happen before the election. So let me tell you, if Biden was in charge of this vaccine, just like the swine flu, he was in charge of H1N1, right, which he can never get right. He can't remember it. It's always messed up. Sometimes he does N1H1. I say, no. But it's the swine flu. I said, just call it the swine flu. It's easier, right? It's the same thing. Call it the swine flu. It was a catastrophe. And his own chief of staff said it was the dumbest run thing they've ever done. And the lethality is much less than what this was and is and was and sort of was, because we have therapeutics now that are incredible. In fact, here I am. I'm here, right? They gave me a shot, Regeneron it's called, and others, Eli Lilly now have the antibody stuff. And I like to say it had no impact, but I wasn't feeling good. I'd like to say because of my physical power, my strength, my young age, I made the case. I made the case. CNN got very angry. I said, I'm not concerned. No, I said when I got better quick. Now, CNN got very angry. Fake news. CNN is totally fake. I said, no, I beat it because I'm in perfect physical shape and I'm a very young person. Well, our first lady got it. She got better. Barron got it. He got better so fast we didn't even know. We said, the doctor said, Sir, Barron has tested positive. I said, for what? And he's very young and very tall. He's seriously tall, and he's a good kid, but he's a strong kid, but he's a kid, and the immune systems. So they said, Dr. Sean, he's great, he's a fantastic White House physician, and he said, Barron tested positive. I said, for what? He said, for COVID. You know, there's like 30 different names. I happen to call it the China plague or the China virus, because it's more accurate, right? And like, you know, about 14 minutes later, I said, how's Barron doing? Oh, he's recovered fully. I said, Barron, were you feeling bad? I didn't know anything, Dad. I didn't. What was wrong, Dad? No, they, you know, they have a very strong, by the way, speaking of that, get back to school. Get back to school, okay? Get back to school, right? Look at Ron saying agrees. Seniors will be the first in line to get it, and we will, we're making it available free, because it's not your fault that this thing happened. And the vaccine, by the way, with or without the vaccine, we're rounding the turn, but the vaccine makes it go faster. The vaccines are going to be out very soon, very, very soon. Our vaccine will eradicate the virus, end the pandemic, quickly restore normal life. I just want normal life, you do too. All we want is normal life. I'm looking up to the sky. A friend of mine said, you know, you're the most famous man in the world. I said, no, I'm not. No, I'm not. No, he said, no, who's more famous than you? You are the most famous man in the world. What are you talking about? Who's more famous? I said, Jesus Christ. And I don't want to take any chances. So I looked up and I said, and it's not even close. All right. But next year will be the greatest economic year in the history of our country. Joe Biden's plan will delay the vaccine, postpone therapies, crash the economy, and lock down the entire country. He doesn't mind locking down the country. The country could not stand it. You know, we locked it down shortly. We did it. We figured it out. We protect our elderly people, et cetera. But he thinks it's fine. He loves that whole deal. I'll tell you, all he talks about is COVID. He gets up today, he's talking, COVID, 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 COVID. And the truth is, we have done an incredible job with the ventilators, the vaccines, the therapeutics. But all he does, because he's got nothing else he can talk about, because no administration in the history of our country has done what we've done. I say it all the time, in the first 3.5 years, what we've done with tax cuts and regulation cuts and rebuilding our military, which was totally depleted and a disaster. What we've done with our military and so many other things, you know them all. Nobody's done, and they never even question me. You know, the fake news with all the cameras, it's never like where they come, oh, you shouldn't have said that. Nobody's done. And think of it, Space Force. We could name, right? We could name so many different things. Under the Biden lockdown, countless Americans will die from suicide, drug overdoses, deferred medical care, and you'll have no school, no graduations, no weddings, no Thanksgiving, no Christmas, no 4th of July, no future. Other than that, he's doing a fantastic job. Biden wants to keep everyone locked up, even young Americans who are extremely low risk, like we talked about. He wants to steal the dreams and the future of our young people. You know, one thing we've learned, the computers are great and the laptops, everything's great. And for telehealth, it's been great, where people can stay in. That's really been, I think it's up like 7,000% or something, and it's a great thing. But, you know, for school learning, it's terrible. It doesn't work. It can't compare to a class or a campus. They're trying so hard to say, oh, gee, this is wonderful. It doesn't compare, and it's well documented. You're taking a large percentage of a young life out of play, and it's a terrible thing you're doing to young kids. And it's a terrible thing that's happening with the parents, too, because the kids at school and the parents are working. Now the parents don't know what to do. Many of their jobs are gone anyway. Now you got to open up your state. You got to do it fast. You got to do it fast. Thanks to our relentless efforts, only 3% of the emergency room visits nationwide are related to the virus. Think of that, 3%. Because you know what it is? They only talk about cases. The reason we have so many cases is because we test. If I tested half, you know, they said test, test, test. We test more than any country in the world by far. We have the best tests. These are things that we never even had 6 months ago. Now, if I said, let's cut the testing down in half, you'd have half. Everyone would say, oh, the cases are way down, right? But you know what? It's good because we know if there's a problem, et cetera, et cetera. We know if there's a hot spot. But that's exactly what it is. I mean, but what we do and what we've done so well are the therapies. And if you think of it, the fatality rate is down 85% and more now. Think of that. But they talk about cases because, you know, when you hear 3% of the emergency rooms are devoted, you know, it's supposed to be 100% and the hospitals are going to close. They don't know what's going on. It's been amazing what we've been able to do. But you don't hear them talking about death. You hear them talking about, because as a percentage, what we've done compared to other countries is incredible. And now, especially with the explosion that you see taking place over in Europe. So we've done a great job, and I'll tell you what, our vice president's been fantastic. And you compare vice presidents, and if you don't mind, I'll take the one we have, okay? You talk about a victory at a debate. That was one of the greatest victories at a debate I've ever seen. That one wasn't even close. Our excess mortality rate is 42% lower than Europe's. Think of that, where cases are now surging despite very powerful lockdowns that they've been, they've had very powerful lockdowns. But don't take my word for it. I want to just show you something on a screen, okay? Very special people get this. We have a video on our fight against the China virus and a couple of other quick things. Again, we only do this for extremely important states and people. Go ahead.
Fact is, every time I've called the president, he's quickly gotten on the line. When we asked to get support for that mercy ship in Southern California, he was able to direct that in real time.
What the federal government did working with states was a phenomenal accomplishment.
We got 2,000 of these field medical sites that are up, almost all operational now in the state because of his support. And those are the facts.
His team has been on it. I know a team when they're on it, and I know a team when they're not on it. His team is on it. They've been responsive late at night, early in the morning.
We are working very well with FEMA Region 2 and with the Army Corps of Engineers, building 4 field hospitals. That was a decision the president himself took, and I'm grateful for it.
These were just extraordinary efforts and acts of mobilization. And the federal government stepped up. We needed help, and they were there.
He said everything that I could have hoped for. And we had a very long conversation. And every single thing he said, they followed through on.
We've got to have double the number of ventilators that we requested for that area of the state. And in fact, we got them in, frankly, short order.
Have we lost anyone because we didn't have a bed, or we didn't have a ventilator, or we didn't have healthcare staff? No.
The president was extending support for new swabs. So conversation, commitment, promise made, promise kept.
My problem is I voted for NAFTA.
I'm supporting NAFTA because I think it is a positive thing to do. And I do not pretend to be an expert on international trade matters.
Trade agreements like NAFTA and permanent normal trade relations with China, which forced American workers to compete against people who are making pennies an hour, has resulted in the loss of 160,000 jobs.
The president is absolutely right when he says that China has been cheating for 25 years and that Bill Clinton didn't do enough about it, George W. Bush didn't do enough about it, Barack Obama didn't do enough about it.
The rising China is an incredibly positive development for not only China, but the United States and the rest of the world.
Rising China is a positive development. It is in our self-interest that China continue to prosper. We want to see China rise.
China's a great nation, and we should hope for the continued expansion.
China is not our enemy.
We talk about China as our competitor. We should be helping.
The idea that China is going to eat our lunch is bizarre.
The idea that they are our competition, they're going to beat us, is bizarre.
They're not bad folks, folks.
China's not a problem.
Allowing China into the World Trade Organization, which he supported, extending most favored nation status to China, which he supported, that those steps allowed China to take advantage of the United States by using our own open trade deals against us.
No.
Do you think in retrospect that you were naive about China?
No.
But doesn't he deserve some credit for that? It's better. The USMCA is better than NAFTA.
It is better than NAFTA.
Now, to be fair, maybe Biden's not telling us because he's forgotten his own plans. Watch Biden's staff quickly swoop in to shuffle him along during a quickie escape the basement trip to Pennsylvania.
Here's the deal. One of the things that is important is that keep in mind, although they're going to vote on Barrett, I think today.
That was terrifying.
What kind of country we're going to be? Four more years of Georgia. He's going to find ourselves in a position where, if Trump gets elected, we're going to be in a different world.
You know, I like that because I save a lot of words. You could never duplicate what you see up there. But you see the governors, and then they'll say, although some of them have been actually very good, but we've done a great job. And you see it there, and that's what their real feeling is. But when they get up to a mic, well, I don't know if he's done that good. No, we've done a great job. If you want a vaccine to kill the virus, a job to support your family, and freedom to live your life to the fullest, you have to vote Republican. It's so important. You have to vote Republican. So we're joined today with some really great people, and a man that's right at the top of that list for me is Senator Ron Johnson. I'm telling you, you're lucky you have him. He's a fantastic man, and he's done an incredible job, and he's got a lot of courage, too. And in Washington, he's respected by everybody. Also, Congressman Glenn Grothman. Glenn? Good, Glenn. Thank you, Glenn. And Mike Gallagher. Mike? Thanks, Mike. Great job. Great guys. And somebody that's done a really good job for us, GOP Chairman Andrew Hitt. Thank you. Thank you, Andrew. How are we doing, Andrew? Because we're not going to fire you so damn fast. You'll be out of here, Andrew. No, I think we're doing great, yeah. I think we're doing great. I also want to thank a legendary champion and a Green Bay Packer personified Hall of Famer, Brett Favre, for his endorsement. You know, he's a tough guy. He's great. But 2 days ago, I saw that he endorsed me, and I just want to thank him. He's a hell of a champion. He's a great champion. I look at some of his records. You don't even realize it. But when you look at passing yards and touchdowns, and one thing about him, tough as hell and great and really talented. So I want to thank Brett Favre. Thank you very much. For decades, our politicians spent trillions of dollars rebuilding foreign nations. Now we are rebuilding, if it's okay with you, our nation. I ended the NAFTA nightmare and replaced it with a brand new USMCA. Wisconsin dairy farmers were decimated under the Obama and Biden plan. Just think about it. I only ran because of them. I said that during the debate, too. I said, Joe, never thought of this. I ran because of you people. Because you did such a bad job. He had no response to that. With the USMCA, our dairy exports to Canada are expected to surge by more than 100%, okay? Just went into effect. And we're not going to be losing our companies to Mexico and Canada. We're not going to have our companies close up and get rid of everybody, fire everybody, and move and do the same product in Mexico. You saw that for... It's probably the number one reason I ran. I couldn't stand watching it. And it's going to be now they're going to pay a tremendous economic price if they do that. Joe Biden is a corrupt politician. They took millions of dollars from the Chinese Communist Party. While Vice President Biden shipped your jobs to China, how the hell can he negotiate with China with the money they take? And the news they don't want to cover it, the fake media, the lamestream media, and the companies, right? These wonderful companies that obviously don't love our country. It's suppression. They don't want to cover it. If Biden wins, China wins. His son walks in, takes out $1.5 billion to manage, billions of dollars a year. They walk in, where's Hunter? He wants to know where's Hunter? We haven't found him. He's still looking for his laptop from hell. That's where he is. Where's my laptop? Hunter, you left it at a repair shop. You never picked it up, Hunter. And you know what they go? Russia did it. Russia, Russia, Russia. Ron, it's Russia. I know, it's Russia. I saw Adam Schiff, you know, watermelon head like this. I believe that Russia caused this problem. Russia. Yeah, here we go. Russia, Russia, Russia. We have a great head of DNI. He said, no, it had nothing to do with Russia. Put out a very strong statement. Nothing to do. If it does, we let it know. We let Russia know. But this is pure, disgusting, evil stuff that goes on. And your tech companies don't want to put it on. Even the New York Post, which had real courage, by the way, and they endorsed me 2 days ago, which I like, but they had real courage. And they took down the New York Post site. Can you believe it? The New York Post, the oldest newspaper in the country, fourth largest of the country, they took down the site. Now, we got to get to the bottom of it, and we will, with guys like Kim, we will. When we win, Wisconsin wins. When we win, America wins, and that's what's happening. Under my leadership, we achieved the most secure border in U.S. history. We have now built over 400 miles of wall. And we'll soon be finished. They don't talk about the wall anymore. They used to kill me. I'd go through, we'd fight them, and we'd close up, and we'd do all sorts of things, and they would go after me. Once the wall started, and once they saw we had all that money lined up to get it done, and the impact it's had is incredible. It's not completed yet, but it will be very soon. And I built it exactly as Border Patrol and ICE wanted it, exactly. I said, what about concrete plank? They said, sir, that's no good, have to see through. Well, how about this, and how about that? All, I know it all. That's what I like. They said, sir, we want steel, we then want concrete inside the steel, and then we'd like rebar. I said, can you think of a more expensive way, maybe? But we gave it, and then we want on top an anti-climb, you know, the thing on top. I said, why are we doing that? That's very expensive. The piece of steel on top, it's 4 feet deep. They said, sir, that's called anti-climb. It's harder to climb. I mean, I gave them everything. Now they have no excuse. I don't want to have any excuses. And our record, our numbers on the border are phenomenal, the best we've ever had. Joe Biden has pledged to open borders, mass amnesty, nationwide catch and release. You know what that is? That's when you catch a criminal, murderer, rapist. You let the criminal go. We argued about this during the debate. He said they all come back for a trial. No, they don't come back, Joe. Only the ones I said with very low IQs come back. You have a trial in 2.5 years for murder. You have to come back. We released them, and I ended it. It's all ended. Okay, you think that was easy? It's not easy doing this stuff. It looks easy, but it's not. Sanctuary cities from coast to coast. They want to have sanctuary cities all over the place. And free health care for illegal aliens, which will bankrupt your Medicare and your Social Security. You will not have Social Security if you do that, or Medicare. We all have a big heart. I do. I want to take care of everybody. Problem is, you have millions of people pouring in from all over the world if you do this. As your president, I will protect your borders, I will protect your families, and I will always protect your Medicare and your Social Security. And I've always said it. Biden and Bernie Sanders, crazy Bernie, one of the greatest losers of all time, this guy. No, but I meant that in a nice way. He lost, and he went back to the Senate and voted radical left. Then he lost again. I mean, Elizabeth Pocahontas, Warren, all she had to do is get out a couple of days early. He would have won every one of those states, but she decided not to do that. I don't think she likes Bernie, okay? But Biden will increase refugees. This was agreed with Bernie and the group, and AOC plus three, right? Highly educated person on the environment, AOC. Have you ever taken a class on the environment? I don't think so. Increase refugees by 700% from terror hotspots. So think of that, a 700. This was agreed to. I don't think Bernie was that bad. I think actually Bernie went further left after they made the deal. And I'm keeping radical Islamic terrorists the hell out of our country, okay? If it's okay with you. Look at what's gone on in France over the last 4 days. What's happened in France? We invested $2.5 trillion in the U.S. military, including nearly $6 billion to save the historic shipyard, Marinette Marine. And even more money for combat vehicle manufacturing in Oshkosh. You know, Marinette's doing a great job. I went to Marinette 4 or 5 months ago, looked at what they were doing, and we gave the contract to them, which cost me a lot of states, but that's okay. But we gave that to Marinette. They do a great job. They do a great job. They were ready to close. A $6 billion contract, and it's going to be extended. They make the most beautiful ship. You have to see, it looks like a super yacht, except it's got weapons all over it. You know, I would say paint it gleaming white and call it a yacht, but the weapons sort of throw you off a little bit. You got more guns and things than that. I've never seen anything like it. Anyway, but they're fantastic. Biden will close the shipyard down. He will close it down. He will cut your military spending. We need it. And also, it's all made in the USA. It's jobs. It's great. Best stuff. And you know what? $2.5 trillion. We're the envy of the world. We're the envy of Russia and China. Nobody has the equipment that we have. Nobody. Stealth fighter jets, F-35s. Can't see them. Tanks. We have tanks. We have submarines. We have everything. What we've done, and nuclear, we've upgraded our nuclear. We have new nuclear. And all you do is one thing. You pray that we never have to use it. Okay? That's the big thing. But having it and having it in tippy-top condition is the best way that we will never, ever have to use it. It's the best way. The last administration's cruel VA policies resulted in deadly wait lists. Under Biden and Obama, 300,000 veterans died on a waiting list. To fix this travesty, we passed Veterans Choice and VA Accountability. Accountability for firing bad people that don't love our vets and take care of our vets, which you could not do under any circumstances. Civil service, unions, whatever. And now you can do it. Jim, you're not treating our vets right. Get the hell out of here. Get fired. Okay, go. Right? And we took care. Now our vets, instead of waiting for weeks sometimes to see a doctor, they go to a private doctor, we pay the bill. And it's actually on it. It's probably less expensive. It's probably less expensive. But much more importantly, we take care of our vets. You had vets getting online by the time they saw the doctor. They became terminally ill. They actually become terminally ill waiting for so long. So now they get out, immediately see a doctor. And recently, we just got a 91% approval rating for the way we're running the VA, the vets, from the vets. We killed the leader of ISIS, al-Baghdadi. We took out the world's top terrorists. Soleimani is dead, number one terrorist in the world. I withdrew from the last administration's disastrous Iran nuclear deal, $150 billion, for nothing. You know what they gave $150 billion? John Kerry, he's another genius. What a deal that was. I recognized the capital of Israel and opened the American embassy in Jerusalem. Presidents have been talking about doing that forever, forever. Many, many presidents. They campaigned on it, and then they wouldn't do it. And I understand why. It was not easy to do. We had tremendous, tremendous pressure on us not to do it. But I did it. I did it. I just didn't take anybody's phone call, that's all. I also recognized Israeli sovereignty over the Golan Heights. They've been working on that for 52 years. I got it done in 2 hours. And instead of never-ending wars, we are forging peace all throughout the Middle East for no money and no blood all over the sand. No blood. Got countries lined up, want to make a deal. They all want to come in after all these years. And the other side and everybody, they all said you could never do it this way. No, you could never do it the way they've wanted to do it for decades and decades. I've done more in 47 months than Joe Biden has done in 47 years. A vote for Republicans is a vote for the American dream. And remember, the Republican Party is the party of the late, great Abraham Lincoln, right? Gotta remember that. People forget that. Over the next 4 years, we will make America into the manufacturing superpower of the world. And we will end our reliance on China, which has already started. We will hire more police, increase penalties for assaults on law enforcement, and we will ban deadly sanctuary cities. They're dead. They're gone. We will end the big tech monopoly and restore freedom of speech. We will defend the right to life, religious liberty, and the right to keep and bear arms. We will maintain America's unrivaled military might, and we will ensure peace through strength. We will end surprise medical billing, require price transparency, already signed, starts January 1st, will be bigger than healthcare, you watch. Lower drug prices even more, and they'll be down 50, 60, 70%, because I've invoked favored nations. The drug companies, Big Pharma, they call it, does not like me too much. They have more ads than Sleepy Joe has against me. Every time you see one of those ads, remember, your drug they're just plummeting. Those prices are coming down. And we will always protect patients with pre-existing conditions, right? All right? America will land the first woman on the moon, and the United States will be the first nation to land an astronaut on Mars. We will stop the radical indoctrination of our students and restore patriotic education in our schools. And we will teach our children to love our country, honor our history, and always respect our great American flag. And we will live by the timeless words of our national motto, In God We Trust. For years, you had a president who apologized for America. Now you have a president who is standing up for America and standing up for the great people of Wisconsin. I am. For some reason, I like you. You know why I like you? Because we had a victory. They didn't think I was going to win. And we kept waiting for Pennsylvania. It was obvious I was going to win, but the fake news didn't want to call it because that would have meant the end. And then out of the blue comes, Donald Trump has won the state of Wisconsin. I said, yeah. Along with Ron, Donald Trump, I was a very pretty sound, and that was it. That was it. You know, you were the one. You got us over the top. You better do it again. So get your friends, get your family, get your neighbors, and get out to vote. Got to get out to vote. On November 3rd or previous to November 3rd, just get out to vote, whichever way you want to do it. Whatever way you want to do it, you got to get out to vote. This is a very serious. We're doing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. I appreciate it. On November 3rd, we must finish the job and drain the rest of the swamp. We've drained a lot of it. From Madison to Milwaukee, from Janesville to Kenosha, and from La Crosse to right here in Green Bay. I love Green Bay. But I love Kenosha, too, because we did a great job there. We showed them something, right? We showed them how to stop them. That was sort of easy, but I love Kenosha. We inherit the legacy of Wisconsin patriots who gave their blood, sweat, and tears for this beloved nation. We stand on the shoulders of American heroes who crossed the oceans, settled the continent, tamed the wilderness, laid down the railroads, raised up the great, great skyscrapers, won two world wars, defeated fascism and communism, and made America into the single greatest nation in the history of the world. and the best is yet to come. It is the best is yet to come. Proud citizens like you help build this country, and together we are taking back our country. We are returning power to you, the American people. With your help, and we are doing that. Have you noticed? A lot of things are changing very fast in D.C. We need this final step. It's going to be something. But with your devotion and your drive, we are going to keep on working. We are going to keep on fighting, and we are going to keep on winning. We are one movement, one people, one family, and one glorious nation under God. And together with the incredible people of Wisconsin, we have made America powerful again. Our military is so powerful. We have made America wealthy again. Look at what's happening to our country. We have made America strong again. We're doing it with our incredible law enforcement and everyone else. We have made America proud again. We have made America safe again. And we will make America great again. Thank you. Thank you, Wisconsin. Thank you, thank you, Green Bay. Get out and vote, please. Get out and vote. Most important election of your lifetime. Thank you, everybody, very much. Thank you.